ladies and gentlemen of YouTube. It's time for more Metal Earth Kits. And what I've decided to do, I've been building a lot of the sci-fi comic book and kits such as that from games. And most everything that I've been doing is medium or moderate difficulty or higher. Haven't done much in the way of easy. And I thought it would be a good idea, and it could be helpful to some, to go back and do some of those easier kits and do more of an expanded video. I edit the videos out a lot. I edit a lot of little pieces out to concentrate it, because it takes hours and I don't want to make several hours worth of video and bore people to death. What I've decided to do is start with something simpler, like the Empire State Building. This is a easy kit. It only has one sheet. I don't believe there's a lot of parts to it, or at least a lot of, maybe a lot of folds, but I don't think it'll take very long. And the idea is I'm going to show you more of what's going on. I'm not going to edit it as much and talk a little more detail about what I'm doing, so that those who are wanting to get into these kits can get a feel for the basics and kind of work my way up, or work our way up, to more complicated kits. And I'm going to start with the Empire State Building. This one I think will be fairly simple. It's mainly going to concentrate on right angles and folds, not anything that I can see in the way of curves. But this is an introduction, and then I'll just kind of go from there doing other kits that have more complicated parts to them. But let's get this started. Let's open this up and see what's inside. We have our neat little package here with the building, and you can see the sheet inside, bits and pieces of information to get you interested. And on the back, some of the other stuff in the collection, a bit about the Empire State Building. Not a lot to it, flashy packaging. Let's open up and see what we're up against. Sheet of instructions and a sheet of metal. This is a easy kit. Instructions are just one-sided. There's not a lot to them. This is a great place to start. With the instructions, you have this one sheet. It's kind of long, and you'll notice there's a solid line kind of marking it off into four different sections. First section up here, we have a little introduction bit, line drawing of the kit, and a sheet. We have some information about insertion holes. Fold lines can be seen as shown here, and it's kind of pointing to it. Insertion tabs are inserted and then folded. So you have the tabs here. You have the hole insertion holes or slots, and you basically put these tabs to those slots. And depending on the situation, if you look below this, you have a legend or a key. Basically, you've got a blue circle. If you see that beside the connection, beside the tab and slot, insert tab and bend 90 degrees. And this is for most visible areas. And then you've got the green triangle. Insert tab and twist 90 degrees is best in some areas to ensure a tight connection. And you have another little diagram here. Pull and screw metal tab 90 degrees to tighten. And that's true. And over here, there's a usual little bit in pretty well every kit that I've built. Needle nose pliers are helpful for assembly, and they are. This is probably one kit that you can do just with tweezers. But if you're going to do more of these kits, you'll want to get a nice set of needle nose pliers and probably a few other things. And I will show you what I use here in a moment. And then you have the diagram of the metal sheet that comes with the kit. And that's not right. There we go. And you've got all the numbers here pointing to the different parts. For instance, number one right here points to this part. And that's where you start. So you come over here, the assembly flowchart, And it starts with part one, part two, part three. And you just put them together, fold them, and assemble them as shown. And then once you're done with this, you go to this bottom corner over here and continue with parts 4, 5, 6, 7. And then slide over here, 8, 9, 10, 11. And then you've built the kit. And it's a good idea to have some sort of magnifying glass to build these kits. And I often forget about this, and it depends on how your eyesight is. Certainly there are people that do without. My eyesight is not so good. I rely heavily upon the magnifying glass. A lighted one is suggested, preferably. This one, little stand, got it inexpensively at Harbor Freight. And I just position it where I'm working, open up the top, and I've got a magnifying glass, and I work on the part. There's headgear that you can get that has magnifying glasses in it. I've seen people use those. Whatever works for you. Some of the tools that I'll use. Pliers. Pliers are very helpful. I have a flat nose set of pliers, and this is from the Fascinations kit. And I have a long needle nose pliers. They can get into a lot of areas and hold on to long parts. These do not have any ridges on the inside, so they do not scratch up the kits as you work with them, and they're spring loaded, which is nice. Side cutters or flush cutters are, in my opinion, essential. You can do these kits without them, but it is so very, very nice to have something to cut the parts off of the tree nice and quick and even and easy. Tweezers are very helpful. They're very small and easy to manage. They're great for holding on to small parts, great for making small bends, great for twisting and bending some of the tabs. I like to have an assortment of different kinds. I have a fairly normal set of tweezers, a thinner set, and a couple of sets with very pointed ends for getting into very small areas. We have our instructions, our metal sheet, and some tools. Let's get started. For starters, we find part one on the sheet as we did earlier, and it is this piece right here, and it kind of matches what we have. And when I first started doing these kits, I would bend the pieces back and forth by the tabs until they broke, and that's certainly something you can do. I highly recommend getting some sort of clippers, and it took me a while to find some that worked. I had some clippers similar to this. Couldn't get them to work. I tried, some people suggested an X-Acto knife. That didn't work for me. I ended up breaking the X-Acto knife. These are from Fascinations. It's a tool set. I have a video on that tool set. These work excellent, and they're good for just sliding into that area and snipping. And in no time, you have the part off. Without doing any damage to the kit. Ta-da! So we have part one. Let's go ahead and get part two off because they obviously fit together. And here's this. So, instructions basically show you to fold this thing around into this shape. Now, it doesn't give you the detail of how to do it, but you can look at the picture and kind of see how this goes. And give it some thought about how I want to do it. There's really not a lot to it. It doesn't really say for the top part here, but this basically hooks into that there. And that particular tab bends over, and this can be a bit tricky to do. I'm going to try and hold this side part and bend this over with my fingernail. Or at least get it started. That didn't work so well. could have used something different. Here we are. Sometimes you really have to make sure you hold flat the parts that you don't want to be in, or you'll end up in a situation like that, which is not impossible to get out of, because it is metal, it is flexible. And I'm going to take these and pinch that tab down, if I can get to it, flat. And there we go. Now, what we need to do is bend these side tabs outward. And I'm going to use these pliers or tweezers and just bend it at a right angle. This is a longer piece, so I'm going to use a longer set or a longer grip part here, tool. Just very easily bend it. Because this is long, we're going to kind of go up and down it as we bend to make sure the entire thing bends. And repeat for the other side. It takes a little time to make sure everything's in the area. You want to try and get them as correctly angled as you can. I'm holding them up so that I can look straight down them to make sure things are angled correctly. Whoa. And these little pieces like to catch on your fingers. Can't tell you how many times I've moved a finger and threw a part. Go to this side. Do the same. Easily work my way up and down it. Another option would be to use these new nose pliers, actually. Why that didn't occur to me, I don't know. Sometimes you are not able to get these needle nose into the area that you need to. This is not one of those times. We are. That was faster. There we are. And these pliers that I use, the insides are flat. They're not ridged, so they don't scratch up the parts you're working on. So we've got that shaped like we need it. Now it's time to do the bottom part. And if we look, this folds around and these parts go into these tabs. So what we're going to want to do is kind of carefully fold it so that it's inside of here. Carefully fold it so that part one is inside of part two before we completely close it up. Just go ahead and bend sides most of the way. Oh. This doesn't really show a preference to either side. A lot of times it's not exactly clear which way to fold these. Usually when you've got the dotted line on the inside of the fold. You can kind of see along here and along there. From that direction, it's dotted. From this side, not as much. Usually that more prominently dotted area goes on the inside. But it's whatever you think is going to look best, really. So, may have bent that a bit far. Okay. And slide these two tabs into place. And we want to carefully bend them over. There's different ways you can bend these. Fingernails with tools. You can try and grab the tab and twist over, although sometimes that doesn't get it nice and flat because of the thickness of the tool you're using. Or just place a flat side against the tab and roll it over like so. You can always give it a bit of a pinch with the tool to help it more so. And then, now that we've got one side on, we're going to try to roll this side into place. This might be a bit tricky. We go. A little bit of wiggling. Get things into place. This one, there we go. Get one of these mostly secured to hold it together. Alright, I've got them partially bent over. Kind of work them the rest of the way down. There we are. And should have and didn't. Should have slid this into place too. A little bit of flexing. And there we go. Fold these tabs down. Now that we have more mass here, it'll more easily work into place. Now, on the instructions, you can see these bottom tabs fold out. So we'll get the needle nose pliers again. Carefully roll these out. Another little thing to consider. And I don't do this. The metal sheets, these metal parts do tend to pick up fingerprints really easily because of the nature of what they are. So there are people out there that prefer to wear gloves. And that bent more than I wanted it to. So let's try and straighten that back out. mostly good. And now we have the first two parts on, and a little arrow points us down. And we need to fold these two pieces in. And then part number three, there's two of them, one on either side, so we have three side by side down here. And then these, as you can tell, you just fold the sides in. And these, you match up the two edges. So that turned out pretty good. If you look along the edge, either way, they're pretty well lined up. Not perfectly, but really close. Line this one up. Let's go ahead and do both of them. And again, I'm putting these flat areas with the obvious kind of dotted line on the inside. And these areas, you can see the dotted line, but there's also a kind of engraved part that's, in my mind, to make it easier to bend on the appropriate spot. So I usually put those towards the outside. And then these go with this flat side up. Tab, there we go. Sometimes you have to persuade the tabs to go into their areas. And these are to be folded over too. So we'll see if we can't fold those inward. Oh. Alright. Have a very pointed pair of tweezers. It could come in very handy for getting this little pin started. Part of the problem is bending the tab without bending the entire thing. Now the other side. So it really does help to have a few tools to make a neater bends and folds, and just a little bit better quality. Aren't going to bend so far because there's not room, unless you want to bend them outwards, which I'd rather not do. And we've got these two parts added, and the next step really doesn't, it just shows the finished, for the time being, finished bit. So open this up to the next section, and I'm trying to keep it so that I can still see the sheet. Sometimes I like to look ahead to see what's coming, because that can help me figure out whether or not I want to do fold this or bend that until I've got that part on. It's just good to look ahead to see what's coming, and I'm looking at this and I'm thinking, this isn't closed yet. The instructions have said to leave it open. There's a reason. What is the reason? Oh, it's a tower. Okay, so now I know. Make sure to do what it says and leave it open for now. 4 and 5. So we have two part fours. And part 5, it says times 2 and it doesn't show the other one, so I'm assuming it's on the other side. So let's start by getting the two part fours, just the part fours, so I don't mix those up. And as you see in the diagram, the model is kind of like this, and this part four goes on this corner. So let's fold this appropriately. Okay, it's gonna be a bit interesting. Double check one for this corner. These tabs aren't folded all the way out. Things aren't lining up because I haven't folded this appropriately. Okay. Double check. Make sure I'm on the right corner. Easy to get mixed up. I tell you how many times I've gone to adjust a part to go back and think I'm putting it on in the right spot, and I'm not. This is a delicate one, so let's again use this. Try to pinch it down with this. This goes on the opposite corner. New part five. Same story. We're just going with opposite corners now. I'm glad I have these little bitty pointed tweezers. Because without them, trying to bend these tabs over, I would have very likely bent the model up. Not meaning to, not wanting to, but it would have happened. Again, some people are more skilled than others. I am nowhere near an expert in this. I've done a lot. I do the best I can. I'm absolutely positive there are those that will put my work to shame, in a sense. Sometimes not all of the tabs will go straight in the first go. Sometimes you just have to take a moment and lock down a couple of them as best you can. Did not. Then try to work the other two into their spot. We are. Now I accidentally bumped this top part down, and I didn't mean to, but I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna leave it like it is because I don't want to bend it back up and then hit it again and then repeat two or three times and that will break off. So I'm just gonna leave it the way it is, and when I'm ready to put this top part on, which is soon, then I will come back and address that. That is one way you keep from breaking parts. Do not bend them unnecessarily. If you accidentally bump it over in the process of doing something else, just leave it. Because if you leave it bumped over, it won't get bumped over again. Just open it back up when the time comes to actually use it or do what you need to do. Here we have part 6, which the instructions show times 2. It only shows one side, so I think it's safe to assume that the same part goes in the same spot on the opposite side. There's 1, 6. I just need to find the two parts 6. And since they're both part 6, I will just go ahead and clip both of them off right now. Whereas more complicated situations, I will only clip off one or two things to try and keep from getting mixed up. Parts 4 and 5 are very similar. Rather than clipping off 4 and 5 and then getting possibly mixed up, yes, you could take the time and tell that there's a difference, but I'd rather just be more careful and not clip them off until they're needed. Let me fold the tabs over, or the sides over. Something else that I've seen people do is get magnetic sheets and go ahead and clip all the parts off to begin with, and then place them in the same order on the magnetic sheets that they were on the model or on the metal sheet, so that the clipping is already done and they can just focus on build the model. And that's not a bad idea. It's not something that I do. I am too clumsy and I get things mixed up. So this is a bit tricky, trying to make sure these tabs are going into the tabs and not the window. I think that's got it. Now we need to reach up inside of there and try to twist these, and that's going to be tricky. See if we can do that with my slightly angled tweezers. Don't put particularly care for how far up these tabs are. And you know what? Honestly, I think I would just rather bend them over. It is not necessary, in my opinion, to twist these tabs if you can bend them over carefully. Difficult part is getting these into where they belong. Trying to get that to sit flat there. All right, I've got that flat. Now, I've got one tab partially twisted. See if I can't finish folding the other. And I'm just sliding this up in there, pressing against the side of the tab, trying to roll it over. There we go. And then we have the tab that's at top. I try and just push it. There we go. So it says the twist. That's not a very good angle in my opinion, and it's not absolutely necessary to do that. These are models that are going to sit on a shelf and look pretty and hopefully not be played with. At least at my house. Yours may be different. Now to fit this in on the opposite side. Here we go. I have to kind of work this part in and spread the sides a little bit to get it flat. And the same thing, I'm just going to try and bend these over. And I've got these. There's different tools you can use. I've been known to use an X-Acto knife. Just be careful with the sharp end. You can stick that in there, especially good for more tight places. This was not so much. But I don't know if this will show up on the camera. But you can kind of see where I'm just folding the tabs over rather than twisting them. One I did twist a little bit and one I haven't touched yet. I'm not going to push that with the knife. That's just asking for trouble. Now we have those parts on. Move over to the last section. We attach it to the base. Part 8. It's not hard to figure out which is part 8. Now, these sides bend over and they're kind of long, and one would be able to use the needle nose pliers on the first three, but then when you got down to the last one, this will be bent over and you won't be able to. So what I do with most of the bases is I very carefully hold it kind of in the corner near where it folds, push it against the table to fold it over. Just push it and kind of push it towards B a little bit, and that mostly gets it. I have to go back over a little bit more. A little bit of added. There we go, close enough. So these four tabs fit in these four slots. It doesn't specifically indicate which side the Empire State Building lettering goes on. So if you want to take some time to decide if there's a particular side you want that to be on, then by all means. This part may be tricky because these tabs are probably not going to easily line up. Not all of them. Maybe. There's three, and then the fourth one. Fourth one is too far in, so I'll try and take these, kind of pull out. There we go. And these are definitely a twistable option. Right there in plain sight, at least plain sight right now, but in the end it'll be under the kit, and we just grab the tab and give it a twist. Grab the tab and give it a twist. Push my magnifying glass up because it likes to walk. And we're close to being done. We just need to now put this top section together, which is 9, 10, 11. I missed something. I feel like I missed something. Oh, I did. I missed 7. Oops. Mistake. But that's correctable. We can untwist these tabs. And mistakes are part of it. Sometimes you can overlook something. Which is a good idea not to twist these tabs insanely. And straighten the tabs out a bit more so I can more easily line them up when I put that back on. And what I have missed is number 7, which I realized when I looked and saw these big pieces still on the sheet. And again, it shows part 7 times 2, so there's 2 of them. And it only shows it on one side. We can assume it's a duplicate on the other. And we carefully bend over the sides. Just does sneak in under there. Okay. All the tabs to line up at the same time is part of the trick. Almost. Now, I can get these two and twist them, so I will do that right away to lock them in a place. The other two, yeah, I can get two, I think. These are not as deeply inside, not quite anyway. that over, maybe. So I'm not satisfied with the twist. But sometimes you can only do so much. Can't say I'm entirely satisfied with the way these are fitting together. Trying to get it into a decent shape. Make things fit. I can't say that I'm entirely satisfied with the way that's lining up. Doesn't seem to be a whole lot I can do about it though. Just not lining up as well as I would like. Get these two secured. And it's bending in a little bit, so let's push that back out. That will allow things to fit a little better. Try and push these two inner tabs over. Or upper tabs, as it may be. Pushing down on the inside and in on the outside to try and get things to squeeze together and line up. Best I can here. Let's try and put it back on the base. Yeah, moving on. Let's put the antenna together. And there's only three parts left. These two. We've got one. One has a slit in the bottom, the other one has a slit in the top. So you put the two slits together. And then we try to gram that in this little plus here. program is perhaps not the best word. Now, try and transfer to my other hand. There we go. And a little bit of twisting. We fold these sides down until they meet. And because these are at an angle, the tabs are sticking out at an angle, we've got to put it flat down on here, and they're not going to quite line up. So what we're going to do is bend just the tab inward so that they're all pointing in the same direction towards the connection that they towards our next connection. It doesn't have to be perfect, but the closer the better. And we're gonna open this back up carefully. Try to line up all of these tabs. And the better I've bent them, the easier they'll line up. There we go. And they don't have to be bent perfectly, just enough so you can work them in. Because when they get all the way in, they're going to line the part up properly. Twist all of these tabs. And we fold this down over this tab. And really, not much room to fold in, but let's try it. That'll work. And there we are. We have the Empire State Building. The Empire State Building, all built, ready to put on a shelf. This kit is listed as easy on the Fascinations website. It is an easy kit to build. It's very straightforward. There's only right angle bends and lining up tabs with slots, bending and twisting them, and you're done. There's not very many parts. Very few, actually, compared to many of the other kits that they have. No bends or circles or complicated shaping. This is a great place to start with if you're wanting to get your feet wet with the Metal Earth kits and get an idea of how they feel, how they work, and what they are. In following episodes, I will get into more complicated kits. They're still on the easy scale, but they have curves and rounding shapes, and we'll kind of introduce those. And always, if you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. Thank you for watching, and keep on keeping on.